Hello there guys, Coaster Chal here, Donkster Born, Bob Bill for Theme Parks, and welcome to a Theme Park Newsroom update where today we're going to be looking at some new details that have come out about Lego Mythica, the brand new area opening at Legoland Windsor in 2021. We have the official opening date, we've got ride names, we've got details and story descriptions on the rides. It's all going to go crazy. But before we get started chatting about all of that, make sure you like the video if you loved it, comment down below your thoughts and opinions, subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss another thrilling YouTube video. Also guys, make sure you go and check out the description down below where you can find Twitter, TikTok, Instagram, Snapchat and Discord links, and also the Google Forms link where you can go and check out a way in sending in your video ideas and content suggestions, and you can check out the Legoland Windsor's official separate website on the brand new land. And for now guys, let's have a look at all the details on Lego Mythica. So Legoland Windsor have revealed that opening on the 29th of May 2021 will be Lego Mythica, the brand new area at Legoland Windsor. Of course, it was formerly going to be known as the Lego Movie World. We knew about those former plans. The theme was changed after the cancellation of the latest Lego movie. It was Lego Movie 3. The cancellation of that project has forced them to change the theme. It could be a factor in changing the theme. And of course, Lego Mythica was born. And now the official description of the area states as follows. Every time a child takes care of building a Lego creature, no matter how big or small, unbeknown to them, that creature comes to life in a parallel world. A portal to that world has just been discovered at Legoland Windsor Resort. The incredible world of Lego Mythica is a parallel universe to ours, where Lego creatures come to life full of epic adventures, powerful guardians and mysterious creatures all waiting to be discovered. The first and only theme park land of its kind anywhere on Earth. And now, of course, there are going to be three exhilarating rides in this area. You can soar into a mystical realm powered by imagination on three major new attractions. Now, the two supporting attractions, in my opinion, are Hydra's Challenge and Fire and Ice Fall. Hydra's Challenge is an interactive water ride with jaw-dropping twists and turns. And as you can see by the concept art of the whole landscape of the land, which you can already see on your screen right now, you can see it's the rethemed and refurbished Squid Surfer. Now, Squid Surfer is a classic Legoland Windsor attraction. It's a classic. Comment down below if anyone has not done the Squid Surfer, because it's just absolutely unbelievable attraction. Oh, absolutely unbelievable. Now, of course, this is... it was opened back in 2000 in the Adventureland section of the park. It's a dual water carousel. And yeah, that's the specific details on the Squid Surfer. Now, there's also two family drop towers. Merlin Entertainment's love their family drop towers. Chessington and Alton Towers. This is Fire and Ice Freefall. So Fire Freefall and Ice Freefall. Experience weightlessness with Crystal Flame on Fire and Ice Freefall. Two spinning drop tower rides. However, in the building, the big building, the UK's first flying theatre attraction will open. Flight of the Sky Lion, which is the concept we're going to put on your screen now. So brace yourself for the most exhilarating ride of them all. Take flight with Maximus on Flight of the Sky Lion, the UK's first ever flying theatre. Now, of course, Blackpool Central, we know, are opening their flying theatre as part of their development in the future. But, of course, this is the UK's first. So, Legoland, you've got the record. You're building the park brick by brick. So, the UK's first flying theatre takes you on a thrilling expedition through the realms. You'll come face to face with some of Lego Mythica's rarest and scariest mythical creatures, and be sure to watch out for the dreaded Chimera. So, it's very, very interesting as to, you know, how the whole thing comes to life, and it's exciting to see all of this become unveiled, and you know, it's wonderful to see that, and it's wonderful to see the plans come to life now, and to see the area start coming to life. And of course, through the construction site, we know that we have the obviously the construction site's been picking up the pace over the last few months, so obviously everything's getting ready for that 29th of May opening date, and that's a wonderful you know, opening day, because it means the whole area is going to be polished off. If it looks anything like the concept art, we're going to look forward to a wonderful, magical, mystical theming expedition of joy. That's the best way of putting it. So Lego Mythica really does look like an amazing new area at Legoland Windsor Resort, a great refurbishment of that section of the Adventureland area of the theme park. And obviously, I did say about Lego Mythica, I don't think it's done any Lego toy sets with the Mythica brand. I might be wrong on that, comment down below, but I've not seen anything from that. But overall, this is a nice original brand, if that's true, for Legoland Windsor Resort. And it's a great storyline for the area as well. So there we go, ladies and gentlemen, thrill seekers of all ages, that is looking at Lego Mythica's details. So we've got Flight of the Skylion, the UK's first ever flying theatre attraction. We've got Hydra's Challenge, which is a re-theme of the Squid Surfers, the interactive dual water carousel, and also the Fire and Ice Freefall, the two family drop towers. Now, from the concept art, I'm not too sure who the manufacturers are. They could be Zierra. They look like Zierra. Which I believe is the manufacturer of the two family ones going into Poulton's Park, the Tornado Springs ones, the Windmill Towers they're called. I believe they're the same manufacturer of them, and that's all done in the style of Tikal at Phantasialand in Germany, you know, that kind of family drop tower. And looking at Tikal, that's a wonderful themed family drop experience. And the Windmill Towers look unbelievable at Poulton's Park. This is just on a completely different level theming wise. Absolutely unbelievable. That and the Windmill Towers and probably Tikal just underneath. Those three are just packed in this theming creation of joy in the top three. And, you know, they've done a really cool job with thematizing the whole area and creating and embracing the audience and making them feel embraced in this mythical experience. And I think they've done a wonderful job in making the area feel just as themed and atmospheric as the rides are, because I'm sure the rides are going to be wonderfully themed. Obviously, flying theatres are wonderful attractions. It's great to have them in the UK now. This one, the one going into Blackpool Central, is the London Resort going to get one? We don't know that yet, but Blackpool Central definitely with their flying theatre, and obviously this one's the first one opening on the 29th of May this year, the Flight of the Skylion. Now, obviously, there's been one main concern from the enthusiast community about flying theatres, and it depends on where you sit, because you might get the ceiling above you if you're on a downward floor of the seating area. But it's all about the screen as well, because if the screen sets up in a curved way, if you're right at the end, you're not going to get the full experience. You're going to get like the curve of the screen. So is it going to be a complete flat screen and the seating's completely flat and it's sort of... So it means that you all get the same experience. It'd be nice, it'd be wonderful. Because I think that was a big criticism of, I think it was either the one at Ferrari Land at PortAventura or it was the Volterra at Europa Park. I think the whole thing about the screen was the big concern with me for that one, looking at it from an off-ride perspective and looking at videos, etc. I think that the curved screen is not a good idea. I'll go for a nice flat screen, a nice big flat screen. To give people the full experience from either side, from one end to the other, from up to down. And overall, I think that's the main thing for me. But apart from that, I can't wait for this. If they do that, they've sold me completely. So I think the Lego Mythica is going to be a wonderful experience. I think it's going to be a wonderful all-ages experience as well. And I think the thematization is going to be absolutely incredible throughout this area. So thank you very much, guys, for watching this Theme Park Newsroom update on Lego Mythica's creation at Legoland Windsor. Some new details coming out about ride names, opening date, everything, all that good stuff will follow. Thank you very much, guys. My name is Coast Shell, keep living the coast life, and I'll see you guys next video very, very soon. Take care, guys. Have a Lego-tastic day. We're building this channel brick by brick.